Hi, I'm Nick Bolton from Firetrust.com. Today I'm going to show you a video of our VPN, HideAway, getting up to speeds of 3.7 gigabits per second. It's really fast. But let's be honest, this test is a bit unrealistic for most people because these days the max connection speed you can get at home is around 1 gigabit per second. And most of the time you'll realistically get half that. Speeds above 1 gigabit per second for businesses start to get really expensive. But still, it's fun to try and see how fast we can get in real life. Maybe we'll all be on 10 gigabit connections in the near future. Okay, on with the show. First, let's see how we tested. We tested with a server set up at packet.net as they offer on-demand 10 gigabit per second connections. So you can spin up a server and pay about $1 an hour. In this case, we fired up a couple of servers in Amsterdam. On one server, we had Windows 2016, where we run the HideAway VPN program, and the other we had a server set up for the VPN server part. So they're in the same data center. We used three different testing services. First, Netflix fast.com speed test service. So the connection goes from HideAway VPN on Windows to our VPN server, then to Netflix's fast.com service, and back to our VPN server, and then back to our Windows box where HideAway shows the results, or the speed test shows the results. Normally you can't test VPNs on fast.com because most VPNs only use UDP, but HideAway uses TCP and UDP. Then we used the speedtest.net Windows client. It kept on thinking we're in New Jersey and the Windows client doesn't allow you to change the location. So that's where we tested the speed to. In reality, it's probably a pretty good test to go to a faraway location anyway. Then we did a test over the local LAN. So that's from the Windows computer straight to the VPN server. Normally, HideAway ignores anything on the local LAN, but we made a special version that can use the local LAN addresses so we could test the speed with it. On to the results, and then we'll show you the actual tests being run next. With these results, HideAway was faster for download speeds than not having a VPN. Most people are going to ask, how does it do that? Well, that's our secret sauce. With the fast.com service from Netflix, HideAway had a top speed of 3,700 megabits per second or 3.7 gigabits per second compared to 3.5 gigabits per second without. Speedtest.net had a higher top speed by almost 300 megabits per second for HideAway. Over the local LAN, the speeds were pretty close and of course much faster as there's nothing to get in the way of a fast connection. On average, using HideAway VPN was faster than not using HideAway. In reality, these speeds are fast anyway, no matter what you're doing. And it's an interesting test to do. VPNs typically cause a noticeable amount of speed to be lost over a connection. And in past tests we've done, HideAway is at least 2 to 6 times faster than other VPNs. One of the nice things about HideAway is that it connects instantly. There's no waiting 10 seconds for it to connect like other VPNs. Additionally, even if there's lots of people on the server, it won't slow down as it's only constrained by the amount of bandwidth. So we can get away with cheap servers with hundreds of people on it without any performance problems. Give HideAway VPN a try today. I'm sure you'll find it easy to use and you won't lose speed on your connection. It's free to download from firetrust.com and try. And there's no sign up required. Okay, let's watch the actual tests being run. So the first is without HideAway running. The first test there was 3.4 gigabits per second, then 3.5. This is on fast.com. I've actually sped these videos up by 2 times, just otherwise it's quite boring to watch these things. And now we start HideAway and restart the browser just in case there was any caching going on there. And the first one is 3.5 for HideAway. Oh, HideAway gets up to 4.1 there briefly. 3.7 it ended on. And 3.5 there. And 3.1 gigabits per second at the end. So HideAway got some pretty fast connections, and this is HideAway on again. This is the speedtest.net going all the way to New Jersey from Amsterdam. So some fairly good download speeds there over that distance. The upload speeds weren't nearly as good for both, but I'm not sure why. But definitely the download speeds are very, very quick. Upload speeds being less important for many users, I guess. And another test for HideAway. I think we did 4 tests on this one. So yeah, this got up really, really fast. So 3,500 megabits per second. And not so fast on the upload. Now we stop HideAway and start speed test again. So this is without HideAway. We're going to the same server in New Jersey. I'll just reduce HideAway so you know it's not being used there. And same with really fast download speeds, not so much on the upload, but we were just going to test the download speeds anyway. And yeah, some really fast times. One more test. And it gets up to about 3.2 gigabits per second. And next we do the local LAN test using an open source program called iPerf. So as you can see, we've got Windows on the left, and on the right we have our server, our VPN server. So you can see that it has actually been running. This is with HideAway running. Sorry, the results are a little bit hard to see, but what it does is goes back and forth to the server and measures the speed. These computers will be almost next to each other, I think, in the data center. So it's just a test over the local connection. And then we did some tests without it, and HideAway was slightly faster on average. They're not using HideAway. And there you have it.